Hey, what's going on? You know who it is. You know what it is. You know what? I decided to make this video in regards of some news that came out this morning. You know, at the end of the day, it don't matter how much evidence you provide to people and proof. You know, people gonna believe what they want to believe regardless, because they in denial about what's going on. But they quick to point out what's, you know, quick to point out what's going on one person's side or one person's perspective. At the end of the day, I done made this very clear. I'm not finna be a nut hugger for nobody. And that's real talk. I'ma stay neutral and I'ma keep it fair, because at the end of the day, some people just got extensive earwax in their ears and they just are in denial about what's going on. They gonna listen to whatever type of BS that's just put out by other people no matter what. Now, earlier this morning, I put out a video talking about, and I'm going to probably do a live stream talking about this in regards to Terrence Crawford basically saying that he's frustrated that he can't get any of the PBC fighters to fight him. You know, at the end of the day, it's just the same old bullshit, the same old regurgitating that that he need to go elsewhere and all that type of shit. Okay, well, let me give you the scenario of this. Okay, what happens if he does go elsewhere? Let's just say he goes where everybody wants him to go, and then certain fights still don't get made. Then what is everybody going to say then? What's the excuse that's going to, you know, what's the excuse going to be then? Because at the end of the day, before Errol Spence's incident, it didn't look like we was nowhere near getting Errol Spence versus Manny Pacquiao. It took a while to get Errol Spence versus Sean Porter. Danny Garcia didn't have any interest in fighting Errol Spence until possibly sometime next year. So you had a lot of in-house PBC fights not get made, you know, or possibly get made with hesitation. So like I said, even if Bud goes to PBC, it's no guarantee that he's going to get certain fights, because people are still caught up in this, you know, one group of people is power to the people, still hell-bent on looking out for blacks, and that's just not the case. At the bottom line, all these promotional companies, no matter who they is, whether it's Matchbox, whether it's PBC, whether it's Top Rank, their bottom line is the almighty dollar. The only color mostly they see is green. Do I like how some of these fighters are getting treated where they at now? Absolutely not. But here's the thing. A lot of people, once again, don't want to bring this up, but I'm going to talk about it. And then at the end of the day, it should have got talked about, because I was one of the very few people that talked about this. You know, as you guys know, I was in attendance for Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder Part 1. They had a list of fighters who was in attendance. Showed them on the Jumbotron. Now keep in mind, they showed a lot of fighters that was in attendance on the Jumbotron. One of the fighters that they showed that's not a PBC fighter wasn't a PBC fighter then, was and not a PBC fighter now, which is Triple G. Now keep in mind, Triple G was a promotional free agent, and I know they was trying to entice Triple G to come over to the PBC. Triple G ended up signing with DAZN, and Triple G's stature has went down tremendously because of the opponents he's chose to fight. But lo and behold, you have a guy, Terrence Crawford, who's in attendance. And you had a lot of these so-called reporters that, you know, at, you know, that was on the PBC, you know, the PBC train, didn't even want to acknowledge the fact that Bud was not acknowledged being in attendance, and he was the WBO champion at the time. And while the PBC doesn't acknowledge the WBO now, they wasn't acknowledging it then. and they could at least show Bud on the Jumbotron, and I had a big problem with that. But at the end of the day, I kept my silence because I was, you know, if I would have spoke out against it, you know, I would have been accused of not being on code, which now all of a sudden, now people are speaking out against the PBC and some of their politics. But I knew about this for a while. Because at the end of the day, you just got people that's just going to be PBC nut huggers no matter what. And I'm sorry, I'm not rolling like that. Not rolling like that. Because at the end of the day, there's still no excuses for certain fights not being made. Because like I said, Deontay Wilder isn't the top ranked fighter. But the fight with Tyson Fury got made. Even though Tyson Fury could have got this over with back in May. But nevertheless, the fight got made. It's going to happen. It's official. It's booked. It's stamped for February. And then, once again, when I bring this subject up, people got all these excuses about so-and-so need to go here and he need to go there. Well, you know what? Tyson Fury didn't have to sign with the PBC to get the rematch to Deontay Wilder. You know, he still is with Frank Warren and he's with Top Rank. At the end of the day, fights can be made. You know, if you jump over hurdles and you really want to fight, fights can be made. So, I know somebody gonna say something slick in the comment section, but that's fine. Don't say nothing too slick. That's all I tell you. Because at the end of the day, I don't care about no lawsuits. I don't care about none of that shit. And at the end of the day, here's the thing. I'm gonna do an interview with Bob Arum, and I'm gonna just flat out ask him what's going on. I'm going to try to set it up, try to get a one-on-one with Bob Arum, because I think it's time to ask Bob Arum some questions. Because at the end of the day, it's easy for a person to talk shit about somebody, but then they don't ask them questions when they talk them face-to-face. The only thing you could do is ask him the question. Either he going to answer them or he not going to answer them. So you got to understand, now the narrative has been changed. Now all of a sudden, you know, that shit didn't went down and shit. Now all of a sudden people is switching the narrative. Now all of a sudden people want to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth about the other side of the fence, which I always had a problem with the other side of the fence based off some of the tactics and politics that I've seen go on behind the scenes. So, like I said before, if this does happen, come to fruition, then what are you guys going to say then? What's the excuse going to be then? Because to me, it seemed to me, it's a lot of excuse making. Like I said, at the end of the day, nobody's going to control what I say. At the end of the day, nobody's going to tell me what to say. Because at the end of the day, I'm just seeing a lot of excuse making being made. So what if Bud does go elsewhere and then certain fights don't get made? It's a saying, be careful what you ask for. What is the excuse it's going to be then? Now his contract is up, I think sometime in 2020. Okay? Because people talking about, you know, Bud is being exposed because he stayed with Top Rank. Or you could also make excuse that it's the other way around. That the people and the fighters on the other side, they being exposed. Because keep in mind, Sean Porter, see now people putting emphasis on the fact that, you know, and this is what I mean by people change the narrative. People putting emphasis on the fact that Bud said that Sean Porter is his buddy and he ain't gonna be forced to fight him. But keep in mind, Sean Porter said that he wasn't gonna fight Bud first. And people seem to have memory lapse when it comes to that. And then you had people saying, well, I'm not going to fight this dude right now. Of course, I'm going to go an easy route. But then people love to bring, well, I don't need this guy, you know, on my resume to go to the Hall of Fame. I don't need him. And then people, oh, see what I mean? See what I mean? But then when you hear other people say, well, I'm going to take an easier route before I fight you, then people get quiet. then you don't see people pushing the record button. And I'm not talking about no specific person, so don't call me talking about I'm sneak dissing. I ain't sneak dissing nobody. It's just a lot of people that do that shit. So I'm not trying to hear that shit. It's lame. People got to show some consistency, man. And a lot of times people don't show no consistency. That's just what's going on. That's just the bottom line, man. For real. I try to show consistency. I didn't put some of the quotes that Bud didn't said that I wasn't too cool with. And then I didn't put some of the quotes that other people didn't say. But the thing is, people only have, you know, people seem to get memory lapse when it comes to certain shit that's said when you got people that are just nut huggers of one particular side, no matter what. Like I said before, I'm going to stay neutral. I'm going to stay even. This is your boy Town Biz. I'm out.